हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू द न्यू लेक्चर ऑफ कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टॉक्ड अबाउट सम हाउ रिलेटेड टू द रेफरेंस ग्रुप। टुडे वी आर कंप्लीटिंग द टॉपिक ऑफ रेफरेंस ग्रुप विद इट्स काइंड्स। सो रेफरेंस ग्रुप, व्हाट इज मीन बाय रेफरेंस ग्रुप? अ रेफरेंस ग्रुप रेफर्स टू अ ग्रुप टू विच एन इंडिविजुअल इज कंपेयर्ड, or any group that individual uses as standard for evaluating themselves. A group which we are using a standard for ourselves when we are comparing ourselves to others, or which we think that we are belonging to that group, or we wish to join that group. So that is called reference group. Why we are studying reference group in consumer behavior? Because marketers are using reference group to target its customer. It plays a key role in the personality of the consumer, how he makes a purchase decision, which type of product he likes. All these characteristics only will be able to know because of the reference group to which a person belongs. So that's why we are very much interested to know about reference groups and its kinds. There are some types of reference groups. Number one, associative reference group. Associative reference group is that group to which we belong formally or informally. Sometimes it needs formal membership in case of formal reference group. Like example is your class group, your semester group, your football club team or group. Somewhere you need formal membership, somewhere you need informal membership. So that is called associative reference group. This group requires formal membership as in a university class, or informal membership as in a group of friends who meet regularly in football. It means to become member of this group, to become member of associative reference group, you need to fulfill certain criteria like your university semester group. First you need to do matriculation, then 12th grade, then you will be able to take admission in university to start BBA. Certain criteria was there. Same is the case with football club. You need to play for years to become able to join a club. So that's why we are calling it associative reference group. Second is aspirational reference group. Aspirational reference group, that group which has inspired you, which has motivated you, which has encouraged you, which has attracted you. You want to become member of that group. You want to become a person like the member of that group, but now you are not member of that group. That group is called aspirational reference group. Like some of our students want to become the player of national football team, but they are not players of national football team right now. So national football team is aspirational reference group for them. So how he has written it over here, these are the groups to which we would like to belong but currently aren't members. Now we are not members of that groups, but we want to join that group. We want to make ourselves able to become like them, to be among them. These groups hold high esteem, means they have got a status in the society. They have got a brand name in the society. That's why we want to join them. That's why we want to become like them, to be with them. Like in England, English football team, very famous team. So how marketers are marketing them, how marketers are utilizing this aspirational reference group. They are making shirts of English national team. They are making dress of English national team for kids. So they are utilizing this aspirational reference group. Next, we have got dissociative reference group. Opposite to associative reference group, dissociative reference group. These are not famous. Famous means people are famous for good works or deeds. These are notorious groups. But now, people don't want to join that group because they hate these groups. In each culture, in each society, every country, we have got such types of groups, political groups, sports group, cultural groups, etc. These are the groups to which we don't want to belong because they have different values and life patterns. Their lifestyle is different, their values are different, they are giving importance to something else that we don't give importance to those things. So these are called dissociative reference groups. So this reference group or reference groups are used by marketers to know about these groups and then to target their customers, to divide the customers into different segments based on these groups, to advertise products based on these groups. They are using these reference groups as a marketing tools to attract customers to themselves, to sell more and more products. You see, in every country, there are different football teams, football clubs. So they are making different dresses of football teams or clubs. With the help of those logos and monographs, they are selling these dresses to the people. Or different political parties are there. Their logos are different, their dresses are different, their wearings, all these things are different. So this is how marketers are using these reference groups as tool for their marketing and advertising and to promote their sales. Thank you very much, students. Be with me for coming class. Khuda Hafiz.